How has the condition affected your life?
It's affected my life in different ways. I know I'm lucky in the sense that the symptoms in my case have been fairly minor. For example, once you have seizures, you lose your driving license. I lost my driving license initially for 6 months. After 6 months, I got my driving license back. Unfortunately, 10 days later, I had my second seizure. So I lost my driving license again for another year. So it was 19 months in all. Now, for some people, that's devastating. It can affect their work. It can affect their independence. It can affect their sense of isolation. In my case, it didn't matter. I've never been a driver who enjoyed driving. And I've taken a pride in overcoming that problem using public transport. And the good news was, because of, I lost my driving license because of my condition, I received a bus pass. So I was able to travel on buses free of charge, which did give me some liberation and reduced a penalty. And the same on trains. I have a discount on trains, which allows me to travel at a cheaper price and take somebody with me. That's fairly practical things. At another level, it doesn't half make you focus on what matters in life. You know, I was getting older, and then having this condition where I woke up in hospital not knowing what had happened, that made me realise, yes, I could have died. People thought I'd had a road traffic accident when I went into hospital. I hadn't, luckily, but my head was pouring with blood. I'd fallen and cut my head open. And, you know, it was quite scary for other people. The people around me who were sitting around my bedside, they were shaken. And certainly for me, it gave me a sense of, this is it, Frank, make the most of your life, don't mess around, don't wait for tomorrow. And my standard phrase I use is to people when they comment on things to me, I say, I have a certain urgency. It's my sort of little cliche which helps me to explain why I'm keen to do things and enjoy life and make the most of the life opportunities I still have. For other people, it's different. Many people suffer stroke-like symptoms. Some of the people here today, young people, are partially paralysed. It was often diagnosed in the old days as a stroke because the symptoms are very similar. It was only with the invention of the MRI, multiple resonance imaging scan, which has allowed people to see inside the head and detect these cavernomas without performing an autopsy. You have to die from that. So that's been interesting for those people. And for young people, you know, I was an older person. Unusually, I was very old in cavernoma terms. Most people experience their first symptoms of a cavernoma when they're in their late 20s, early 30s. Young people here this weekend often have an early diagnosis because being the genetic form, the symptoms appear earlier and more seriously. But to appear, as in my case, at the age of 58, well, I was very lucky once again. Still, though, it's a niggle. I've had two seizures. I'm not on medication, but I live with the thought that any minute, right now, this minute, I could suddenly collapse with a seizure. And hopefully people would deal with it properly, would understand that I'm not drunk, that I'm not on drugs, and that these things happen, and I won't hurt myself. That's, you know, seizures can be quite alarming for the people who are around, rather than for the person who's suffering it. We suffer afterwards with the fear of another seizure and its effects on our lives.